and welcome to Spicoli TV, live from a shed somewhere in Tampa, Florida. So sit back in your chair and turn up the volume. It's time to laugh. And if you're not careful, you may learn something. So for the next 2 hours, let Spicoli and Smitty entertain you. Call area code 813-402-6724 to participate in madness. And now your host, Spicoli. My job is done here. I think I'll go play with Smitty's balls.
Warning, the following content may contain elements that are not suitable for some audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.
Introduce the song, Smitty.
The number one streaming radio show from inside your computer.
Mic's not on.
How about a little Def Leppard rock and roll, fans? Let's get her done. It's time to go. Hey, I don't do this crap. I'm not sure why that camera's on. I'm not this guy on this chair. This is Spicoli's chair. What the hell are you doing? Everybody better watch Spicoli TV every Friday night. I don't give a damn what you're doing. Stop and come and see us. Right, Devil Dog?
You got it. I got your back, man.
This is Q from ThorQuest, and you're watching Spicoli TV. Why is there a dead Pakistani on my couch?
There's no need to fear. Underdog is here.
When criminals in this world appear and break the laws that they should fear and frighten all who see or hear, the cry goes up both far and near for underdog.
Speed of lightning, power of thunder, fighting all who rob for plunder, underdog.
Welcome to the show. Hello, kids. I am Spicoli.
For the headlines read of those whose hearts are filled with greed.
Smitty loves this song. I knew you would like that. Welcome to the show. I'm your host, Spicoli, sitting over here, underdog himself. Where's your power ring?
The ring on my finger I do fill with an underdog super energy pill.
Where does he find the super energy pills? Does he buy them at the local pharmacy?
Yeah, you gotta get them. Those are prescription only.
It's a big jar, prescription only. Is that a Class C fucking drug?
It's definitely Class C. Wonder what it was.
I don't know. It made him, gave him his
Viagra?
Powers. Could have been.
I bet that's Viagra.
We never saw an underdog boner, though. We never saw an underdog boner.
Alex Jones.
He did have it for Sweet Polly Purebred, but.
You know, he boned her.
Welcome, everybody, to the show. The phone lines are open, 813-708-8878, 813-708-8878. You can call the 402-6724. It is a phone message you can leave on there, and we'll play them back on the show if you want. That's up to you.
Yep.
Everybody on the chat board right now, I got Geo, IRN Broadcast, Josh, Show With No Name, Tampa Devil Dog, Smitty, Nitwit, Doc. Dr. No himself.
Don't forget to bring a towel.
Yeah, right. Minnesota's here.
Minnesota, baby.
That's right. Our, what? Three-time champion? Three-time?
I got it short.
I need to do mine. Mine's ready. It's so big now that I have to put tons of mousse in it.
See, people don't know.
Early tonight. Can I tell you? Hold on. Oh, yeah. It didn't work with the shit. Ginger ale. Really? Ginger ale. Seagram's. Ever had Seagram's?
Seagram's, 7-7.
That's great with 7-7.
Yeah, I have a ball to go to tomorrow.
A ball?
A ball. So I got my hair cut. I said, cut the hell out of it. I want it nice and short. I got to be in a tuxedo. So.
Holding this one back. You ready?
Yeah.
Let me get my joke foster here. Hold on. I got one for you, Smitty. You ready?
Uh-huh.
All right. What is a tight pair of pants and a cheap motel have in common?
Tight pair of pants and a cheap motel. Stuffy inside.
No ballroom.
No ballroom. Is it an AC/DC ball? No, I don't think they're playing.
No? No big balls going on?
Nope. Aww, that would be nice.
That would be nice.
No, I don't think they're going to be there.
No, they're probably going to
have
some...
You guys got a hearing issue.
They're going to have some big band with fucking orchestra shit playing on. There'll be a harpist.
Nice.
You're going to have to learn how to do the foxtrot and the gigolo and all. What is it?
The sax player.
Can you do all that slow dancing shit?
Oh man, I'm a carpet man.
Are you?
I rip it up on the carpet.
Now, do you lead or you let her lead and you just follow along?
No, I'm the leader.
Are you?
That's right.
I'm a follower because I don't know how to do shit when it comes to slow. I can just kind of like stay in one spot and kind of
moving
around. That's just about it. But I can't do all that other.
And I can do the African anteater dance.
That's the African anteater ritual, dude.
Hey Beavis, I need some TP for my bunghole. That's right.
Yeah, that's fun stuff. I've always wanted to learn how to dance like that, but you gotta take lessons.
I don't do that.
I can't believe you rented a tuxedo. I mean, damn. You gotta take pictures now. I gotta see you in a tux so we can put it on the website. Can I tell you for the first time tonight in we've been doing it almost a month now? No dinner pics tonight. Nobody participated. I was the only one.
You know what? It's a busy week.
Everything's transitioning.
I figured
that.
A lot of stuff's going on. I didn't really.
I'm saving them for next week.
Yeah, I didn't really have a great dinner. I know Minnesota's got a ton.
I'm sure he will.
I think he wears a tutu. Uh-huh. Yeah, I'm not afraid of a tutu. I've worn a tutu to the races before.
like the, Cheech wore in that fucking
movie? Yeah, the race downtown. I did. I was Vision Man. I had a cape,
wow,
a big eyeball on my chest, and a.
I should have worn that big red thing, the red man suit.
I did. That's what I'm saying. That was me. Vision Man.
Wow.
Well, you know.
You were a vision, all right? A vision
clip-on
of love.
Clip-on bow tie? Absolutely. It's not a clip-on. It's pre-tied.
I saw the other night two people wearing, back-to-back, wearing those damn shirts that look like you're wearing a tuxedo.
Those would be
cool. I had one in the 80s. Remember when they first came out? I had one.
I wonder what my wife would do if I showed up at the ball with that on.
No, you should get the kind that you can rip away. It has Velcro on the sides.
Oh, and have the real tux under the t-shirt.
No, just wear the fake tux and something underneath that's off kilter, and then in the middle of the ball, just rip the like frickin' James Bond or something.
Yeah.
Shaken, not stirred.
Hey, it's not my thing. Did they ever find Brady's jersey? I don't think so.
I don't know. I don't really care. it doesn't do me any good. I don't have Brady's jersey.
So I know we're going to go to the Snapple Cap here in a second. Correct. But I wanted to talk about, I heard something on the radio today. It was hilarious. I don't know, disturbing. So it was a perfect topic for me to talk about.
Okay.
It was cheating on your wife.
Wow.
And what classifies cheating on your wife?
I imagine... communicating with some girl in a conversation, and it be any kind of, you know, innuendos. Yeah, that's
cheating right there.
That's the start right there. It's the fucking gateway right there.
So the penis doesn't have to make penetration.
I don't know.
You can cheat before that moment.
It depends.
See, Gio says insertion. I don't know.
Sexting. See? Just sexting.
Sexting. But if you're walking down holding hands with another woman, isn't that cheating?
Yes.
I mean, I would think if you got caught just doing that.
True.
Yeah, because she's not going to believe you didn't fuck her yet. Mm-hmm. She'd be like, I know you fucked her already.
Yeah, right. So, damn, it'd take more money than that.
A blowjob is not cheating.
No.
Who's giving it?
What is that old proverb? Eating ain't cheating.
So they got this new thing they're opening up. It's these brothels.
Right.
They're opening up sex clubs. Except
Where?
In Tampa. It's a sex club, except you don't have sex.
Joe Redner run?
No, you don't have sex with a real woman. You have sex with one of those dolls. No. Those vinyl. Wait. All right, I understand.
No.
I'm just saying. You have sex with these... you go in and you had sex with these real. They look like they're real.
Unless it's new out of the box, I ain't doing sloppy seconds on no mannequin. I'm sorry.
It's bad enough I'm fucking a doll, but I went second? How sick am I?
That is. What if you were like sloppy 105th or something?
So
I mean, do they have?
It's plastic.
No.
How long does the slide work? The slide's still working, ain't it? Seriously, I mean, it's plastic. It's there.
Oh man, sloppy turds.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, people are paying $125 to go and have an hour sex with these vinyl realistic.
How desperate dolls. Are you if you're going to go have sex with a doll for $100? How desperate are you? I mean,
look,
seriously.
Don't look down on me. I only did it once. No. I'm just kind of curious. I mean, would that be considered cheating? If you're married and you go to this brothel of rubber dolls and you fuck it, is that cheat?
I don't know. I think it's just stupid.
It would be stupid, yes. But I don't know. Is that cheap?
Would Galvin be there first?
Oh, no. I have a penis on from what I understand.
That's right.
What I remember. But I'm serious. Hey, SJ, welcome. I'm serious, though.
Watermelons are cheaper, says Jim.
It's true.
You could bang a piece of fruit a lot cheaper, man.
A tomato. I'm serious.
Cantaloupe.
Don't knock it till you try.
No. Nick from the Cousin Joe Show used to bang cantaloupes when he was young.
But see, a cantaloupe is hard and cold.
He said the way you drill
soft
it.
And warm.
It's the way you drill it, he says.
It is the way you drill it. That's a fact.
Literally the way you drill it.
It is.
Drilled cantaloupe.
It's a new drink. Think it's strong when you're done.
Hey, baby. Ever introduce you to a sloppy cantaloupe?
Hey, moms, welcome. I got you a drink, honey.
Oh, gross.
You do that, like, see, you should have sex with me. Now you're drinking that cantaloupe. You don't know where it's been.
Yeah, way to go. Way to pull out the fruit balls.
Microwave makes any fruit fuckable.
Who says that?
Geo. It's true.
That's the quote of the night,
it's
right?
True.
Microwaves make any fruit fuckable.
It does. Microwaves make any fruit fuckable. Yeah. That's absolutely true.
That should be on his shirt.
Stan, you hear that? Microwave makes any fruit fucking. Get on that, Stan.
Oh, man, that's fantastic.
He says that from experience, too. That's the sad part. He's saying it from experience.
He was so quick with that. Yeah.
They do.
Oh, my God.
A round of apples.
Look out for the pit. Ooh.
Depends how you drill it, right?
Exactly. I've got to write that down. I'm never going to remember that.
Microwaves make any fruit.
I got
it. Or that's vegetable.
Shit.
Fuckable.
That's hilarious, dude.
All right, so...
that's a patent right there.
So, again, I'm trying to think about where that cheating line draws. Would you think that's disgusting for
yes.
a dude to go to a place
yeah.
and fuck a rubber doll?
Come on.
It's a life-size...
I think you need to sit down and have a conversation with your wife before you...
No, seriously, it's a life... All right,
where are you at in your relationship that you have to go out and buy a plastic doll...
But, man...
Excuse me,
be
not
what
buy.
You want it to be.
Rent.
Yeah.
Literally a cum dumpster.
Hey, come on.
She's a plastic cum dumpster.
Then
that gets to that show.
Get the pressure washer going.
Dumpster. That's gross, man. What the hell is wrong with people?
So it's a guy going to a place, having sex with a life-size realistic.
You gotta wear a condom.
Why? They do recommend you to wear a condom. Well, you know, it's a rental. If it was your own, you wouldn't have to. You could bareback it. All right, so you wanted to go do that, right? But that's like weird and creepy, isn't it?
If she's a dildo without you, that would be cheating just the same.
Well, that's what I'm going to say.
It's a different ballgame.
You think it is?
Yeah.
So a dildo that's vinyl, plastic, whatever.
At home, though. I mean, she didn't go out and rent it.
So you've never been to the place where you rented
it? No, I didn't know you.
You never been
do
there?
Do they do that now over there?
That's what the same thing.
They spent all that money at that fucking place cutting down the parking lot. Every morning I sit there next to the Todd because I drive across the street. There's one of the first apartments I do is like right on the other side of the street of there.
Yep.
And I watch people cut that corner. And they've since cut the parking lot now. They used to stand there because they built the bus stop.
Turn around, go behind
going south,
that way or whatever.
Going north, I'm sorry.
Yeah,
going north. They got the giant bus stop on the right-hand side in front of the Todd.
Yep.
Yeah, well, people used to cut that parking lot because of the stupid bus. So the Todd put, like, all these cones. They still jump the parking lot. So now what the cops do is they'll stand behind the parking lot with their bikes, and they'll wait. And people will jump right through, and they just walk out and go, hey, what are you doing? You know, it's a $150 fine to jump the parking lot.
Yep.
To avoid the light.
Yep.
That's not good. I learned the hard way once.
Smitty's pocket pussy. Look, I don't know which way I could go on that. I don't think I could do it.
I know I couldn't do it.
I mean, well, I don't want to say I know I could. I don't want to throw it right out. I haven't seen a picture of these dolls, but I heard they're really good looking, realistic.
Wouldn't you be better off, though, buying one for yourself and having it at home?
Okay, let's say
that's a whole different ballgame.
Instead of renting it, you buy it at home. What do you hang it up? Hang it in the closet?
Honey, I'm in the mood for sex today. I'm not. All right. I'm bringing out Sheila.
Dragging the sex doll into fine, fuck you. You
drag old Sheila out the carpet. Back of the closet. You start banging her right there.
Oh.
You know, sorry, honey.
How embarrassing is that? You guys have friends over and they open the closet?
What the hell is that?
What the hell is that?
That's Sheila, the sex doll. She's great. You want to give her a go? No, I'm good.
No, I'm not going to let you. Wouldn't that be crazy? You have to, like, hide that shit.
Should
in
we
the
take up
wall?
A collection and get Smitty and Spicoli a doll to share? Oh, man. I don't know.
When do you have to replace them?
Yeah.
I mean, after how
they're
many
warranty?
Years? Yo, that shit didn't last long at all.
How do you empty the dumpster?
It's full.
My God.
The Sheila-like anal. I assume there's three holes on those
things. I assume there better be.
I mean, what's the difference, really?
Nothing. Nothing. It's just the wishful part.
70,000 mile rubber on them. Is that a radio?
And this made by Firestone.
It ain't balanced, man.
Sheila wasn't made of Firestone. She's a Goodyear product.
Could you imagine asking your wife, honey, I want to have a threesome.
I want to bring out Sheila the sex doll.
Look at her, honey. She'd be like, what the fuck
what
is
the hell is this shit? This is Sheila. What do you do? She
runs
does
lab
she
technology.
Just lays there and takes it.
It comes with the little plugs. You're right. No, it's a solid
it
thing.
It comes with plugs.
Put the counter
God.
On your cock to keep the mileage.
Oh,
yep,
my God.
Every in and out is a...
is that all season rubber?
Hey, I eat glue. It's weird, though. I don't know, man. I don't even know what to think about that realistically. I mean, you say you wouldn't bang it, but...
God damn, we should call the Todd and ask some questions right now. You think they would talk to us over the phone?
They don't have a good attitude up there.
No, I noticed. I would think not.
They're not jokesters, no.
Excuse me, hello? We're calling about Sheila the
snow. She likes chains in the winter. You got your snow tires on, honey?
I'm going to doing some grounding and pounding here in a little while.
But you know what? If you had to do one of them, I'd rather do the full-bodied one than just that little tiny piece that's like just a pussy.
Yeah, no, exactly.
Lay that on the bed and just fuck it. That's embarrassing. Your kids walk in. Dad, what are you doing? I mean, how do you explain that one?
You can't explain
the
it.
The life-size doll, you get away with it. Cut the other covers. That's right, it's another woman. He's like, Dad, that's just some kind of ass thing.
A block of pussy is so creepy. That's, you're right, it is.
Yeah. I'd only do it standing up. I wouldn't lay on it. I'd do it missionary with it.
Cover it all up and shit. Like a walrus.
Sorry, man. Take her outside and hose her off. That's right. Hose
off for twat.
You got the nozzle in there. Press
get the high nozzle.
I better clean it this time. I didn't do it last time.
Yuck.
I just took a nap. That's too much work, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, really?
I'm starting to get a visual now in my head.
What if it looked just like her?
Wow. Man.
But it was just a doll frozen.
Yeah, that would be creepy.
Move the hand around. Like,
you can teach her to give reach arounds.
Take her out to eat. We'll take two steaks.
She doesn't eat much. She's dieting.
Oh.
Where's the water go if you shove it up her veg? I don't know. It's got to come out somewhere.
It's got to be like a douchebag.
Comes out her ass and her mouth. Like all three holes are connected. It's like a fountain.
So when you're fucking her, you just come right up out of the mouth, get you right in the face. What you, the hell? There's a check valve on this thing.
You know you've hit bottom when it when he comes out her mouth. What the fuck?
That's right before you doubles, put the gun in your mouth.
Doubles as a spring when needed.
What?
That would be hilarious.
How do we come up with these topics? I heard it today. It's just crazy. I don't know what I think about. It kind of turns left, but
I can't get the visual out of my head, dude.
Hanging on a hanger.
You know they weigh. They weigh. They say they weigh like 100 pounds.
You gotta carry her around, shit.
You gotta lug
it. Got her in the wheelbarrow. Rolling her in the backyard. Hey guys,
I don't let her get on top because she's dead weight.
Do you buy lingerie for her, or do you ever dress her, or is she naked
she's
all the time?
Naked all the time.
Never get her. Don't even get her clothes.
No, why?
Maybe some shoes.
Do you have to take her outside and get her
tan her up? Yeah.
Hard enough dragging out my real right.
Carry her too.
Got her in a headlock by the hair. Come on.
At least she gets me in the carpool lane.
Oh, my God. Shit. This
gotta
hilarious.
Dress her up sometimes.
That's funny shit,
Smitty. All right, well, you ready?
Yeah. Late. Oh, God damn. Funny stuff, man.
Hey, man, wanna play a game?
All right, we're going to play our first round of Snapple, kids. Stand by.
Cool, let's play a game.
She's self-propelled like the tractors. That's great. Geo throws out wow and blows off Devil Dog. Whoops.
Hey, kids, this week's Snapple Cap Fact coming up right now. Don't go anywhere.
Snapple Cap Fact time, kids. Snapple Cap Facts come
Minnesota.
Zero through 1,399. First one in always gets two picks. Dr. No, otherwise known as
Minnesota, baby.
Our current champion.
Minnesota, baby.
But to be the man, you gotta be the man.
Woo!
I found Nitz bot. Well, give us two, Dr. No. You were the first one in.
Mm.
Welcome to the Breeze checking us out. The Breeze. Welcome, Breeze. Pick his Snapple Cap numbers 0 through 1,399.
I thought I felt a draft.
Feel the breeze!
That was from Ken Griffey's home run.
Ooh, feel the breeze!
Playing a game, kid! That was the best part. When you don't play, the umpire stops the game, turns around, knocks on the screen, and goes, "Playing a game, kid!"
Yeah, Breeze, we got you. 69, that's a good number. We got a 55. Got a lot of low stuff. Got a couple of high ones up in the 1200s.
All right.
Ready?
Minnesota will be defending his championship. Woo! He is the current three-year champion. First time.
And three-time.
He is the three-time. That's right. He has hit it two other times. Yeah, so that would make him the three-time.
Three-time, three-year.
All right.
Nobody will ever dethrone him champion.
First round is Snapple Apple. Snapple Apple.
Snapple Apple. That's for future note, because you do get a, you get to guess that next time now. The
all right, here we go. Slippery like a plastic mannequin vagina.
After three times.
Oh, that's a good one. Apple's my favorite.
Apple.
That's the freshest. That is the freshest. All right, real fact number. One. Three. Zero. Nine. 1309. In New Zealand, it is illegal to name your twin babies fish and chips. Oh, man, that sucks. In New Zealand, it is illegal to name your twin babies fish and chips.
Sprinkles are for winners.
1309. That sucks.
You were close, man.
I wonder if you can name them that in the United States. Fish and chips.
You can name them anything you want.
Why can't you name your baby fish and chips?
I mean, it'd be okay to go, come here, chips, but come here, fish.
God damn it, get in here. But, Dad, my name's Jesus Christ.
You only missed it by 10, Spicoli.
By 10, huh?
10 away.
Oh, son of a bitch.
1299, 1309. Missed it by 10.
But you can name the theme from Starsky and Hutch. Yes, I could. It's the car that gives it away. It's
how
too
about
early.
Cod and fries.
Cod and fries would be good.
I love cod.
Don't! What up, cod?
I mean,
cod. Codfish.
Sasha and...
Oh!
I heard it. That was nothing but net.
That was nothing but net, and that was a backflip. Yeah. Nice. Nice. I'm on
how
a roll.
How many times did people name their twins in before they had to ban it? See, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, exactly. And what's wrong with fish and chips? It's not...
Isn't that the national food, though? That'd be like naming your twins Bald Eagle.
But didn't that start in Britain? It didn't start in New Zealand.
No.
So why did New Zealand ban it? Oh, fuck it. We don't like fish and chips over here.
I just said so.
And nobody's allowed to talk about fish and chips as long as they're in New Zealand. Go fuck yourself.
That's right.
Fish and chips can go fuck yourself.
Now, if you have triplets,
I say you go eat a pile of fish and chips and go fuck a plastic mannequin.
But if you have triplets,
blow some tartar sauce all over it.
There you go, fish and chips and tartar sauce. Too many drunk parents naming their kids. That's true.
That is true. I mean, it's ridiculous.
Stop whining.
You should have to submit it for approval.
You keep your damn fingers out of my tartar sauce.
Stop whining.
You should be able to name your kid John Mahogoff.
John,
Jack Mahogoff.
Jack Mahogoff. Jack Mahogoff?
Or Mike Hunt. You shouldn't be able to name your kid Mike Hunt.
That's just, I don't know.
Jack Mehoff.
Mehoffer.
Oh my God.
Jack Mahogoff.
Mahogoff? Jack Mahogoff.
You got me. All right. You ready to do this thing?
Yeah, we can jump into it.
Are you?
Yeah. I don't care. Hey, would you blow me?
Hey, man,
That was my cousin.
IP Freely.
IP Freely. Yep. Great Yellow author. River by IP.
Great author. Yes, he was.
Smitty, are you ready to try to match Spicoli, you dumbass loofah?
All right, kids. I got one. All right, the name of the game is called Match Spicoli. It's played just like Match Game, only it's me we're talking about here. So if you match me, you get the point. We'll do 10 words, followed by a 25-point, say it, 25-point bonus question. Always comes in handy. Alright. Got my board here. Which color would you like tonight, Smitty? I got blue, green, or black. Smitty's going with black. I'll take blue. Alright, first word up here. Let me load it up.
It's always past the Geo Knight.
Ready? Blank talk. T-A-L-K. Blank talk. Blank talk. Give you an extra time here. Another extra 10 seconds or so. Blank talk. Smitty's coming up with something. He's writing a lot over there. I see
Stop
that pen.
Whining.
Moving shit going on. I got girl talk, sex talk, shit talk, pillow talk, dirty talk, straight talk, straight talk, straight talk, chalk talk. Smitty?
Chalk talk, that's an Indian. Oh, no.
Chalk talk. All she wants to do is talk. That's true. I said pillow talk. Mm. Pillow talk, that's going to be sticky jello. 1 point.
Good, good, good. Very good, very good, very good. Very, very, very good.
Do, 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 do. All right. Do, do, do. All right, you ready?
Yep.
Next one is 2 points. Blank meat. Blank meat. Breeze slams talk into the face of 13 pillows in people's faces. Pop, 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 pop. Blank meat. Blank.
Mince meat.
Meat.
Play with your meat. There you go.
Mm. Woo! Devil dog with play with your meat. All right, Smitty. Blank meat. Grade A meat.
Grade A meat.
That's some good stuff right there. That's like Kobe beef.
Yep.
I said beat your meat. Mm. Beat your meat. Anybody? Play with your meat is the same. Beat your meat. Jost. 2 points.
Caught the puppy.
Jost
and Devil Dog play with their meat.
And
is
Devil Dog?
Yeah, play with your meat is the same as beating your meat. But also, Geo said pull my meat. So, yeah.
So you're giving it to Geo too?
Yeah, why not? It's the same reference.
I said Geo, Jost, and Devil Dog.
Correct.
Mom's bitch. Yo hoes, what up, Stan?
There we go.
Bang pow?
Bang pow. Oh, yeah, bang pow! Bang pow! Here we go. Fish blank. Fish blank.
Didn't we just talk about this? Fish and chips.
Fish and chips.
Ah, oh, shut it.
Okay, I was watching the... I'm not gonna say this one yet. I'll tell you this in a minute.
Woo!
I've been watching a lot of MASH.
Yep.
It's been on like two different channels now. And I'm like, I can't stop watching it right now. There's a lot of funny ass jokes, and I'm still waiting to find the one where the horse comes into play.
Fishy smell shouldn't be coming from my vinyl girlfriend. Why?
Coming from a vinyl girlfriend. Gross.
Oh my god.
Fish blank Smitty. Fishy smell. Fishy smell. I said fish face.
Fish face.
Fish face. You don't remember?
Yeah, that's fish face.
Hey, look, Dr. No, fish face.
Really?
Yes, Dr. No with fish face.
Damn, Minnesota.
That's great. I can't believe you've never heard the term fish face. I almost said fish taco. But I don't like fish tacos, they're gross.
Filet fish is good.
Filet fish is disgustingly good. Fish face. It's kind of like
fish dung.
Fish cum.
Fish dung.
Fish cum.
Well, I guess if you thought.
Fish cum, fish dung is all the same.
I'm not even sure what it says.
Everything that comes out of fish's ass is what it does. That's
caviar?
Gross. All right, you ready?
Uh-huh.
Cookie blank. Cookie blank.
Cookie cutter, like the baseball fields.
Cookie blank. Cookie blank. Cooking me up some bitch.
Woo! Some titty milk, huh, Minnesota?
Cookie dough ice cream. Cookie crumbs keep getting wedged in my final girlfriend's twat.
You're not supposed to eat it!
Smitty, cookie blank.
I think Vinyl Girlfriend is going to go a long way here.
Vinyl
tonight.
Girlfriend is the
tonight's
show.
I did the same thing.
Cookie dough ice cream. I said cookie crumbs. So cookie crumbs getting wedged in my Vinyl Girlfriend's ass is going to get the point.
Clearly.
Good, good, good.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
Out in the league with 4 points.
All right, this is worth.
She goes everywhere with me.
5-pointer. Here we go.
Take her to the doctors. Get her reflexes.
Blank chair. Blank chair. Blank chair. As long as you can milk the vinyl, you're all happy. Yes? Sonny and Chan.
That's the Mexican version.
I love you, Kirk. I love Sonny you. That is fantastic, Sonny. You know Sonny and Chan, man. They come on that show, you know. Examining Chan. I almost said gynecological chair, but I didn't know how to spell it. Blank chair, Smitty. My vinyl girlfriend rides in an electric chair. Yeah, because she doesn't...
Everywhere we go.
She can't walk.
She weighs 100 pounds.
Quit pulling your meat in my fucking chair.
Why?
Oh,
stop whining.
I said electric chair.
I knew you would.
Electric chair. We got three people. Sticky Jello. Geo, and oh, that was it. I thought
Smitty.
We had three. You said electric chair?
Yes, I did.
Where are you?
My girlfriend rides in an electric chair.
Oh, yeah, well, you're right. Electric. Well, that's not the electric chair I was talking about, but we'll classify.
It's an electric chair.
You're right. It's an electric chair. Cunt check chair. Wow. That's a great answer. I didn't even think of it like that. vinyl cunt, vinyl twat checking chair.
I don't know. I'd be afraid of that.
I would too.
Have a stranger come and look at that?
Well, what do you
That's
think?
That's embarrassing.
What do you think it'd be like to go rent one? Gross. You ready? Blank King. Blank King. K-I-N-G.
Luther!
Blank King. The Sausage King of Chicago. Great answers. Mom is King. Blank King. Scorpion King is good. Burger King. I fucked my vinyl Gorsuch so much she is a crack king.
She is crack king. You may want to slow down.
Try Gorilla glue. That might keep her together.
Stankin' stand. Stankin' King.
All right. Blank King. Smitty?
I did something nice and simple.
Lion King. Wow.
Lion King.
I almost said Mabel King, and I'm glad I didn't because nobody said it. I said Billie Jean King. Nobody said her either. Nobody said Billie Jean King, the biggest dyke in the world.
Hoover Dam's pretty big.
Yeah, well, you're right. That's a dyke.
Yes.
You're right. You're right. Who is that dude?
Wasted kid.
Yeah, she was a shitty tennis player. All right. Let's try this one. Sorry, this is worth 6 points.
You named your vinyl girlfriend Billie Jean King? Take that, Billie Jean King!
Blank dog. Blank dog. Blank dog. Smitty's writing out a fucking story over there. Blank dog. He's still writing. What the fuck is he writing over there?
It's funny to me.
Blank dog, Smitty. What'd you write? Come on, I gotta know. I have a vinyl girlfriend, so now I need a dog. A vinyl dog?
He didn't go out very often.
I pet a dog tonight, and she peed all over my foot. Oh, that sucks. I said hot dog.
Something that simple.
Hot dog. Guest 721.
3721.
The Breeze.
That was 7-pointer, right?
Yes.
Breeze.
That's it. Nobody else said hot dog.
Geo was 7. SJ was 6. Guest 3721 has 7. And Breeze has 7. So that there you go. A sheep is not good enough for Smitty. Now he needs a dog.
All right, here we go. 8 points.
8 points.
Blue blank. Blue blank. Smitty gonna write blue balls.
Blew a load right in my vinyl girlfriend. Oh, he had to say it.
Of course he would. Blue blank. Yuck.
Whitey.
6 months of fucking therapy.
Moms.
Blue bonnet better. Old school. Blue berries.
Everything's better.
With blue bonnet on it.
Woo!
Blue angels. Blue lagoon. Blue velvet. Blue suede shoe. Blue
nice.
Sky. Blue balls. Smitty?
Same thing. Blue sky.
Blue sky. We're going to blue sky that. We're going to sit on that. Blue sky it. I'm wearing what tonight?
Me too.
Blue jeans. Hello? Nobody said blue jeans. Damn it. Not sure somebody would say blue jeans. Nobody said blue jeans.
Blue jean king? Oh.
All right,
hey, she needed the money.
9-pointer, here we go.
Right stand, 20 bucks.
Ten blank. T-E-N blank. 10 blank. Ten is the loneliest. No, that's not the right one. Ten was the name of a what you call it album? Pearl Jam.
And I'll let you fuck my vinyl girlfriend.
Only $10, really? Will you clean the cum out of her when I'm done? Yuck! That's part of the repertoire.
Oh my God.
You must clean out your own discharge.
Ten spot. $10 bill.
10 blank, Smitty. 10. 10.
What you go camping in?
Tent. Oh, that's fucking great. I love it. What's the definition of in tents?
It's
a place where people go sleep when they go camping. I said 10 commandments. Sticky Jello came in just before I flipped this. So I got Dr. No, Jost, and Sticky Jello with 10 commandments. That's a 9-pointer.
Yep. All right, it's a close game. What do you got left now?
All right, this is the last one. It's a 10-pointer and then the 25-point question. You ready?
Yep.
Blank one. O-N-E. Blank one.
SJ's got 15. Minnesota's got 12. Close game. This one is worth 10 points, though.
Blank one. Blank one.
What do you win?
My vinyl girlfriend is always ready. You should get you
one.
You should get you one.
It's true. They never say no.
You win bragging rights and turn the fucking doll.
I turn the fuck the doll. That's disgusting.
Blank one, Smitty.
Mine's easy.
Phone. That's great, man.
Seriously, that came right
phone. Wow. Oh. I never even thought of that. I said the big one, or big one.
The big one.
A big one. You know, just a big one in general. Any kind of big one.
Right,
I see.
I eat glue.
I've got a big one. Showing no name with Big Red One. That was a movie with Lee Marvin and who?
John Boy Walt.
And who? Luke Skywalker.
I got I Eat Glue and who? That's it.
Show with no name. Mark Hamill, yes. He was in that movie. Alright, 25-point bonus question. Let me
load you know what that means?
What? All these other points meant nothing, right?
Meant nothing.
What's the tally? Who's winning? Who's leading?
SJ with 15, Minnesota with 12, Jost with 11, Whitey and I Eat Glue with 10.
All right.
Some other people have some other points, but at this point, it's whoever gets this right.
Whoever gets this right gets the ball game. Here we go. Ready?
Yep.
Tiny Tom Thumb said, "I just played hide and seek with the big people at Sally's house. Nobody found me because I hid in Sally's blank."
Vinyl girlfriend. I don't know.
Hey, Tiny Tom Thumb said, "I just played hide and seek with the big people at Sally's house. They couldn't find me because I hid in Sally's blank."
Yeah.
There's a lot of answers here.
Yep.
A lot of answers.
Sally was an asshole, though.
You think Sally was an asshole? Vinyl girlfriend's twat. Yes, indeed, moms. Tiny Tom Thumb. He's tiny, so he could fit anywhere. Anywhere. That's what I'm saying. 10 seconds. Is everybody in? Tiny Tom Thumb said, I just played hide-and-go-seek with the big people at Sally's house. Nobody found me because I hid in Sally's what? Big-ass mouth. I said I hid in Sally's pocket. Tiny Tom Thumb, he's tiny. Can't fit in your pocket?
Pocket?
Can't fit in your pocket?
Big-ass mouth and pocket.
Nobody
are
said
right?
pocket. No 25-point bonus question. Goes out to nobody, so our definitive winner is going to be...
Look at Minnesota.
Her pocket pussy says...
I had a shot at this moment, and you let me down. I was right there.
It's Tiny Tom Thumb. She fits in a pocket, you know?
SJ. Congratulations, my friend.
SJ, you win anyway. You didn't need to understand the part.
That's right.
I.E. Glue says, what about nature's pocket?
Hot pocket.
That was nature's pocket.
Hot pocket. Right.
That's not what I meant, though. I meant hot pocket. Pocket. I'm all sorry. Right. I let you down. You all have a chance to win again. Coming back in a few minutes, we'll go shopping with Craig. And there's your chance. Or we'll play Snapple again, and you can win there, too.
Nah.
Ah, fuck
you
it.
You can write that
off. Yeah, you gotta write that shit off. But don't go far. We'll be back right after this.
Hey, it's Spicoli. It's Harry. Hey, look, sorry we haven't been around in a while. I don't know if you guys moved or what. I've been calling and calling, and nobody ever answers this damn phone. So hit me up on my celly. I don't even know the phone number. I think you do, though. So hit it up and let me and Buddy know when we can come back to work. All right? Love you, brother. Stupid ass.
Hey, it's Spicoli. Just a reminder, listen to Spicoli TV every Friday night, 9 p.m., right here on IRNBroadcast.com.
Thank you for tuning in. My name is Robert. What can I build for you today?
Yeah, I'm calling about the computer that's on sale. It's $9.99. It's on a flyer that came in the newspaper.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd like to order that one.
Okay, let me confirm everything with you. We have a Pentium 4 processor, 520 with HD technology, 2.8 gigahertz. Okay, DVD player in the first bay and a free CD burner in the second bay. No floppy drive. You want to add a 3.5 floppy drive?
Will this not do a disk? If I wanted to put something on the disk, will it do it?
Yeah, actually, we recommend you the floppy because it's only $30, 3-0.
Okay, no, I don't want that.
Okay, are you sure? Because the future is going to cost more money. Okay, no speakers.
Speakers don't come with it?
No, sir. It's not in the flyer.
Hmm. Okay, well, let me read it a little bit better, and I'll call back.
Why?
Thank
you got the flyer in front of you?
Yes.
And why you call me? That gets back for me. You call me and call me again, it's going to be back.
I didn't realize that it didn't have speakers, and I don't want to have to order speakers for this price. So I'll just look somewhere else and find me another computer.
Oy! I can't believe it, like a little girl. I can't believe it, only for speakers. Go ahead, little girl. Little pussy girl.
This is Herbert, and I'm watching Spicoli TV. Mm.
You want a popsicle?
You damn right. Mm.
Casey Kasem.
Right.
Oh, so does he use, like, the numbers?
Right.
To pick numbers
on the menu.
On the menu.
Yeah, it's brilliant. Really. Good old Richard.
Hello?
Hi, it's me, Casey.
Casey?
I'm Casey Kasem.
That's Chinese restaurant. You want to order something?
Yes.
What's your order?
I'm ready.
Yes, go ahead.
Three.
What number three?
Nine.
The number nine is house best or fire wife?
Sure.
What number?
Two.
You can tell me the watch order because I don't know what number you chose me.
Four.
Yeah, number four, watch order.
Yes.
Okay, it's beef broccoli.
Okay, good. Want another one?
Yes.
Five.
So number five, you want a chicken or pork?
Sure. Seven.
Number seven, it's chicken with garlic sauce.
Oh, no. Three.
Chicken or pork?
Okay, good.
Huh?
Now, on with the countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You got all that?
Okay. We got a number one, it's chicken or pork tom mein.
Good.
Number two, it's chicken or beef tom mein.
Okay.
Number three, is mugu dai tan.
Okay, I got you.
Number four, is pepper steak.
Sure.
Number five, is roast pork or chicken with mixed vegetable.
Okay, good.
Number six, with beef broccoli.
Got you.
Seven, chicken with garlic sauce.
Good.
Eight is baby shrimp with broccoli.
Yeah.
Nine is pork or chicken no main.
Okay.
Eleven is beef or shrimp no main. You heard that?
No. Say it again.
Hey, it's Spicoli. You're watching Spicoli TV right here on the No Name Network every Friday night.
Good evening, Toys R Us. Lee speaking. How can I help?
Hello, Mother.
I think you've got the wrong number.
Oh, that's not your voice. Your voice is lyrical, like the gentle strum of a lute. I'm Stuart.
What do you want?
Tell me where my tricycle is!
You don't get a tricycle.
Trust me, woman, if I could walk on water, I would stroll you out of the middle of a lake and hold your head under until the bubbles stopped.
You're an idiot.
Drunky.
Shut up.
Yes, that's right. I'm calling you drunky, and there's nothing you can do about it because I'm protected by my impenetrable cereal box fort.
You're an idiot. How can I help you?
Yes, I think she and I are going to have a good time together.
Sorry?
I can't hear you.
Hello?
You'll have to speak into the microphone.
Hello?
Aren't I the wicked one?
How can I help?
Cinderella had three wicked step watermelons who were very smelly to her. So her fairy god toilet turned a pumpkin into a fanny and sent her off to the poop. Oh my, how ruthlessly absurd. My, so it's that easy to win you over.
Can we help you?
I've got an army to raise, and I must get to Nicaragua. I require a window seat and an in-flight Happy Meal. And no pickles! Oh, God, help you if I find pickles.
I think you might have the wrong number.
We met on the internet.
You found it on the internet?
I mean...
Stewie, I'm a family guy.
You know my name?
Giggity-giggity-goo.
Why, you tottering, fen-sucked dewberry. I'm going to go find something to strike you with. Excuse me.
Spicoli TV, and now back to the show. Take it away, Spicoli, you freak. Right back at you.
Welcome back to more stuff.
Stuff.
Stuff. All right. Anybody?
There's popcorn popping.
Anybody? Take a crack at this one? Very popular show. Yes, it is the Gong Show, Jost.
Wow.
Chuck Barris. Chuck Barris was also work. Where did he work? Was he in the CIA or some shit?
Navy SEAL or something?
Yeah, something like that.
Gene.
The Dancing Machine.
Hey.
That's the guy.
Wonder how much money he made doing that.
Gene,
they paid him.
They eventually did. You know, he was started out as a he was just a stagehand, and they needed some filler time one time, and somebody knew that he could just, you know, kind of like dance around and act stupid, and they threw his ass out there, and it became a hit.
Yep,
it became a hit. So I love me some Gene the Dancing Machine. Absolutely. We're gonna get to Gene. Speaking of Gene the Dancing Machine.
Were we speaking of him?
We're going to give you your fill of Gene here in a little while. Just sit tight for that.
They paid him in plastic.
I love the fact they used to throw shit at him while he was trying to dance.
I know at the end they all got together. Yeah.
Big hug.
Feelings!
Nothing more than feelings.
J.P. Morgan was a slut.
I'm going to give you your fill of J.P. Morgan tonight too, Minnesota. You better look quick, because it's going to go really fast. That's all I can say.
Yeah. And we don't want any malfunctions.
No malfunctions. There could be, though.
Is she still alive?
I don't know. That'd be a great subject for Dead or Alive, J.P. Morgan. Somebody look it up. J.P. Morgan, still alive?
Minnesota.
How old is she?
Minnesota's already looking at pictures of
her
right
now.
She was
like, what, in her 30s on that show? That was in the 70s? Ugh. She gotta be getting up. My name's J.P. Morgan. Stands for Geritol Plentiful.
I got a vinyl boyfriend.
No, Goldie Hawn was on Laugh-In.
Yeah, she was on Laugh-In.
She was on Laugh-In. That's where she got her start. Yep. That's things like Google and shit. Yes, Goldie Hawn was Laugh-In. She used to stick her head out the little door. Yeah. I loved laughing. Ruth Buzzy used to crack me up. She used to beat the shit out of that guy with a purse. Whack, 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 whack. Yeah, Ruth Buzzy was hilarious. Yeah, who was that guy? He was like a pervert. That guy was like a pervert. Yeah.
Merv the Perv?
Yeah, he used to hang out in the bushes and shit.
What was the one in the Hustler magazine?
She's alive and 85 years old. Wow.
She's alive and 85.
Whoo!
See, fucking keeps you young. That's what I'm saying.
Wow. I bet there's some dust up in there.
Hey! Still getting it every day. So she's still a slut. Probably.
I bet she is. Jane, you ignorant slut. Do you hop around from bed to bed with anybody who would do you any good?
Hi, I'm Rosanna.
Rosanna, then I had a little sweater ball on the end of my nose. That was so funny.
Never mind.
That has nothing to do with what we're talking about. Oh.
Never mind.
Artie Johnson. That was him. Great, great. Well, let's
he
do
was
it.
A German motorcyclist.
He
remember?
Was,
had the
yes. I loved Artie Johnson. Well, let's just...
But it stinks.
It stinks. It stinks in here.
All right, you ready?
Let's just do it. Let's just jump right into it. Have a little fun here. Yeah, I got to play this. I got to play
warning,
the warning.
The following content may contain elements that are not suitable for some audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.
It's going to happen so fast, you will not see it if you don't pay attention.
Tonight. Here comes a
the two
coming,
best
folks.
Things comes, on the Gong Show.
Here comes the Duke of Dillies. The Wizard of...
Whoopee. Oh, no, comic. He was great, wasn't he? Remember the unknown comics come out with a bag on his head? We saw him in all the Bucks games.
Wrestling.
That's the unknown comic.
All right, I am the unknown comic, America's first punk comedian. I tell you, I'm in a pretty good mood. I took my dog to a flea circus. He stole the show. All right, time now. I've been working on some more impressions. This is my impression of that favorite game show, Hollywood Squares.
Look at those
pants
he's wearing.
Peter Marshmallow here, and our first question goes to Paul Lynn. Paul Lynn, how do you keep fish from smelling?
You cut off their little noses.
Oh, man.
Hey. No, you know good thing to smell, not be pregnant.
Hey, Chucky, baby,
get out of this
Broadway.
May the truth be known about the unknown comic.
Wait a second.
What is this?
How do you know that that's his baby?
How do I know this is his baby?
Yes.
The kid looks exactly like him.
Oh, wow. Well, that's different.
I let her jump in the sack with me one time. What the heck?
Jump in the sack with me. We get it? Dun dun dun.
All right. Okay,
hey, whoa! He just chucked that baby aside.
Get off the stage.
He slipped on the water. He sure did.
We'll be back. One more stuff.
One more stuff. All right, here we go. Oh, yeah. I will let you know right now, Whitey, I have this on audio. I will send it to you. Gene Gene, the Dancing Machine music. Gene! Pay particular attention to JP Morgan, folks. Who's the guy with the afro? Is that Bob Ross? Happy Little Tree?
Was there a guy there?
JP looked good there, didn't she? She looked doable. It did look like Bob Ross. Happy Little Tree. Oh! She's taking it off. What? Oh! He got drilled in the head with a basketball. Look, Bob Ross. Look at that stage. Well, if you think you saw something you shouldn't have, we're going to let you know here in a second. Just in case you missed it. Freeze frame. Oh, darn.
She looks like a monster.
There you go. JP Morgan. It's flashing her funnies.
Damn.
She's part of the itty bitty titty committee.
That wasn't a bad committee.
No, not at all. Not at all.
I paid my dues more than once.
But you gotta love Gene Gene, the dancing machine. I just love that.
Told
music.
You she was a little slow. Damn right.
No milk from those titties. And no titty milk going on
there.
You're
going to end up skinny, but you can still survive.
Could you titty fuck them? What if those titties were on one of your dolls?
Titty Don't committee smitty, that's right.
What would you need with those?
Don't forget to bring a towel.
If I'm going to have a fake doll, she's going to have some nice...
Yeah, tits you can bang, right?
She's going to have some tits.
So you can just chafe your Johnson right between them.
It's not the same.
All right, here's another thing with your plastic.
It's real touch.
Let's go back to your plastic doll theory here. Okay. You're going to be banging your plastic doll. You know you're going to have to use a lot of lube, right? Because they don't naturally lubricate by themselves. So it's going to get a little messy.
Yeah.
She's got lube coming out her mouth, lube coming out her ass. All three orifices has lube just pouring out of it.
Mine come with those little Zerk fittings where you just grease gun in it. It's self-lubricating. Every time you push on it, it squirts it out.
It's showing no name. You got to lick it first.
She's a squirter. I'm going to need the squirter version.
Plastic doll will be on its way. Make sure you share.
No, Minnesota. Seriously.
No, don't you dare.
Don't you dare. I know what you're capable of, sir.
Squeeze her boob and she lubricates.
Nice.
Self-lubricating. Oh, yeah. This is nice.
At the end of the night.
Can you have tits added to her back?
He wants the gel doll.
So
yeah.
She's on top. He can reach her.
If you're going to do it, you may as well freak
it
out.
Plastic doll lubricant container.
Hanging on the wall. Whoa. Gotta have newspaper under.
Drip paper.
It's gotta leak. I can't stop that.
It's gotta leak. Oh, man.
It's hard to fix those.
I can't find the bilge plug to stop her from leaking.
I think the check valve's a little stuck.
Oh, that's terrible, Smitty. That's terrible.
Get an Islam doll. They blow themselves up.
Yuck!
Well, I mean, I personally wouldn't do it.
No, but I've heard people that would. Not holding anything against them.
I wouldn't.
No, just take pictures and send them to SpicoliTV@live.com and we'll put little bubbles over them and show them on the show. I think that's a home run.
And he throws it in a deep right. It is high. Middle star. It is gone.
Where? Is it gone? Can't see it. All right, let's go shopping with Craig. It's time to get it done.
Yes.
Hey, man, want to play a game?
You wouldn't blow up your doll? No, I wouldn't blow her up.
Hey, how you doing?
Blow up in her.
Craig. And every week, I like to take articles out there, find out that Craig's
in. JPMorgan.com.
And I'm going to see if I can find me something that I need. I could use a new tractor seat, see? Mine got all worn out.
Look too bad.
I need a new one. So I was looking in there, and I figured, well, if there's other items in there, maybe I could use one, too.
Dude, I'm
going to
send her an email.
Like,
let's get her on the show.
Juicer,
talk about filling
cleaner.
Up her Morgan.
I don't know. Pull out your wallet, bitches. Let's go shopping with Craig.
Tampa, Florida. I'll say it isn't so. Nice. A wall sconce. At a West Chase, 4 like-new wall sconces with glass candle cylinders. I thought sconces were from a bakery dessert. I did, too. So why would you put it on a wall? Why ask why, Smitty? Why ask why? That's one of those big candles or little candles? It looked like it fit all the way down in, right?
That goes about a foot each. Dilly on the board.
Hello, Dilly. Welcome, sir. Welcome.
Are we talking to state champions?
State champion Dilly?
Hey, this is Dilly, and you're watching Spicoli TV.
What the fuck is a sconce? Exactly. That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, a sconce is a dessert.
I thought it was a dessert.
It's Wisconsin. It's from Wisconsin. That's what it
cheese.
Is.
Cheese.
It's part of the cheese curds. That's how they make cheese curds.
Fancy name for a holder.
You're right. Fancy name. I'm going to say 50 bucks.
No, we got
bucks.
Knocked out. Sorry about that.
That Billy. Sucks. I've been
but
there.
But hey, you still did awesome.
I've been there. Get all the way to the championship. Some son of a bitch comes and steals it from you. You get some big fucking cocksucker up there that can score runs for you, and then you don't have anybody to kill the game.
Alright, you ready?
I am now. I got a bag full of pixie sticks.
Oh, shit! It's on! Alright, we're all in?
Yep.
Closest one.
45 dollars. Wow.
Dilly. And Spicoli will share.
All right, Dilly. Pick us a good one.
He usually goes left to right, but he's got a little bit of an issue here.
Number one.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He normally does left to right, but he's got an issue because the Dilly one is in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
This is abnormal for him.
Well?
To go over here. He normally does left to right.
Stop whining.
What could he go wrong with?
Wait.
Seven. Oh. You mean eight, right?
Woo!
So he doesn't want to go with the Dilly one. He wants to go here?
Well, this is really seven eight. Or eight. That's number eight, Dilly.
It's really number eight. I know it's a little blurry. We're thinking he wants to go over here.
Yes. I'm thinking. Still waiting.
I don't know what else. Dilly. Muck, 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 bugger. It does sound like that.
Well, I guess he's going with number 7.
So who's guessed 5590? I don't know. All right, so we're going to give him 7? But he doesn't do that. I'm sure he means this.
I don't know. Dilly!
Woo!
Mic up your mind, mate.
You want 7 or you want the left?
That's a simple, simple, simple thing. All right, if he doesn't answer in 2 seconds.
Tick, tick, tick.
Exactly. Then he's going
to
get...
We're trying to play the game.
The left one. Okay, yeah, so. He wants number 8. We thought so.
We thought so.
Just wanted to make sure. Wanted to double...
That's what he always does.
Exactly. Get your arson gear. Well, you get to double your point.
All right, both of y'all do.
The feed guide. Well, that explains it.
Yeah, well. Good thing you're not in charge of feeding those chickens outside.
That's right. I say you feed them a pixie stick. That'll get them right where they need to be.
All right, you ready? Okay.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Is that a chick? Is that the doll?
It's a vinyl blow-up girlfriend.
Therapeutic memory foam, brand name and original box. Never used. Every woman wants 3 inches in her bed at night. Only 3 inches? That's all they want?
Well, I mean, can't
so,
ask for everything.
So, if I got a pillow top luxury chick bed thing here, and I only gave her 3 inches, I could hit it twice in one night. Totally 70s. I've seen that. It's a music station on one. 35, 25, 80, $3, $30, $26.99, $27. Anybody else? Devil Dog coming in the last second with $50 for a pillow top chick.
Woo!
All right. RF Tech on the board. Welcome, Bill J. Mom's Specialty 75. And the winner with a built pillow top plastic chick cover. $150. Dilly again. Why, Dilly? That's what I paid on Nebraska.
Ouch.
All right, Dilly. That's a lot of money for one of those.
$150.
I mean,
little top 3-inch thick.
Another $100 or two, you could buy the whole mattress like that.
Brand new.
Yeah. Then you could do some real cushion in the pushing.
Vinyl, only the best for my vinyl girlfriend.
I wonder if Dilly's feed died again.
Probably did.
Dilly says number 3.
Left.
Yep, left to right, left to right.
We know that's what he does. We may as well just...
Well, he gets to take 5 points from any player. 5 points from any player, Dilly.
DQ
Orange.
All right. Thanks, Moms. You gonna take it from Moms? No, she's not gonna take it from Moms.
Blah, 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 blah.
Dilly, you get to take 5 points from any
Dilly,
other player.
Pick a player and take 5 points from him. I'll have another pixie stick. Number six. Nom, 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 nom. Nope, 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 nope. Yep, 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 yep. I said moms.
Okay.
All right, next up. Uh-oh. I spilled the cocaine all over me. A 1970s reproduction. Go get your fucking shine box. 5 cent shoe shine box. Exciting deal. Giving it a carnival look. All wood. Two chains on each side. Golden tone or brass tone over the metal. On the edges and the corner. And the closure. Height is 6 3/4 inches high. 11 1/4 inch long. Width is 5 1/2 inches. Remarkable vintage condition. From the Underdog Show. I'd still rather tell you. Yeah, go get your fucking shine box. Hey, I don't shine shoes no more. I don't know if you haven't been in jail a long time. I don't know if you heard.
Yep.
I don't shine shoes anymore. I'm going to say a calm $75.
Wow.
45, 75, 55, 40, 35, a Colt 45, $99, $250.
All right, you ready?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Go get your fucking shine box. 40 bones, baby.
A Dilly.
Dilly with the fucking
and
Doba.
And Nitwit. So Nitwit
picks. Warning. 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 Doba alert.
Go Nitwit picks alert. Dilly shares.
Shares.
Number nine. All right. Well, you get to give yourself 5 points.
Plus five.
That's a good pick.
So go get your fucking shine box.
Dilly out in front with 14.
Wow.
Nitwit with 6. Mom's -5. Spicoli on the board with 2 points.
Hey, at least I'm not in last place.
Caught the puggy.
Exactly.
All right, you ready for the
yes.
next one?
Yes. Oh, look at that. That's sweet right there. A hunting buggy, a hunting we will go. A 22R Toyota hunting buggy with 38.5 Super Swampers. 5-speed, super quiet, hunt all day on a few gallons of gas. Adult owned in a private hunting lease and used a handful of times. Want to sneak around and ride in comfort? This is the perfect buggy for you, and it has brakes. Better have brakes.
They don't all have brakes, you know.
What the hell is that in the front? Look at the bumper on that thing, man. Gator gets in your way, just nudge him out.
Get out the bumper?
Get out the bumper. Son, the bumper, man, back there. Sir, what is your name? Hey, my Pedro the Buckus, man. It's on there on the license. Oh, his name is Ralph, man.
Hello. This thing on. Hello.
6 grand.
I'm going to say 35 hondo.
6 grand.
Rogers bucks. 49.95, 4,500, 5,025. Hey, can I get a 25? 6,000 over here, 25, 45. It's got that there plastic bumper wrench.
Look at that dog. 4,000.
Do you have to own a bloodhound to ride around with?
Yeah, you gotta have a dog on this truck. You can't just drive this truck.
It's part of the process.
Uh-huh. It is. All right, you ready?
Yes, sir. Hunting buggies. $5,900. We're gonna give that one to who?
Who?
Nitwit.
Nitwit down at TV. Granny gets to sit in the back. That's right, because she's got the moonshine.
Jed, don't spill the moonshine, Jed.
All right, Nitwit. I got
a pixie down the wrong tube here. Little dry pixie stick.
Number seven.
Number seven.
There's nothing in here. Oh, wait. Unfortunately for you, sir, you lose all your points. Oh, that sucks.
That's normally Geo's card.
That's normally a Geo, but... seven, jump off a bridge. All right.
That stings a little.
Flowers. Well, those are cute. Beautiful blown glass from Europe. If you get her flowers, you will get blown. Is that
Stop
a guarantee?
Whining.
It's a guarantee.
Because I've gotten flowers, and I'm like four or five blowjobs behind. I don't know about you.
She's letting your jaws rest.
I know, it was the last time I had to give a blowjob. That was terrible, man.
TMJ.
I couldn't get that taste out of my mouth for a month.
Tequila didn't even
know. That was horrible.
$69.69, Bob.
69, dude.
Stan, you only think $15?
I mean, they are. What are they, glass? They're glass.
They're glass. They're hand-blown.
There's no other way than get blown. Hand blown.
That's
she gets that jerking motion
work.
Going. Oh, wait. I slobbered on this myself.
Minnesota, $75. Each, maybe.
That's all you want to hear at the end. Gross. You don't want to hear that.
100.0000001. That was funny last night, Kurt.
Those glass slivers are hard to get out.
Oh, my God!
I collect blown glass. It's spendy stuff.
It is. It's cool shit. All right.
That was his tiebreaker point last night on Battleship, was .0000001 point.
That's a good tiebreaker.
It won.
Let's see. It worked out.
It worked out.
All right. Correct answer is... 170 dollars? Jesus Christ.
RF Tech?
RF Tech with 100? RF Tech with $100.
Woo!
See, says Moms.
Woo!
I told you. Shitty looking blown glass is worth big money, folks. He says Nitwit. I got Nitwit with...
Oh, hold on. Diddy? Diddy bet 100.00001? Yes, he did. Look at that.
I didn't see that.
100 point. Yep. We talked about it, too.
Mm-hmm. I didn't see that.
You
sorry.
Threw me off.
God, you God, threw God. Him off.
Very good, very good, very good. Very, very, very good.
Nitwit pick. Oh, fuck. Rent blown glass is cheaper. Pre-blown glass? Ooh, gross. That's like renting a damn plastic doll.
Number five for jugs.
Still got cum in it.
You hear the bio alarms going off?
Yuck. Gross. Give me points. Whoops.
Stilly's out in front with 14.
Alright, here we go. You get two, add seven.
Oh, there it goes.
Woo! But to beat the man, you gotta beat the man!
There you go.
Dilly 14, Nitwit 8.
Out with the bad air, in with the good. Alright. Next up.
There's not going to be any more glass fucking flowers.
I ain't blowing no more glass around here, baby. Sucking on a real dick. A what? Market. Huge lot of Legos, variety of sizes, plus 100 minifigures with accessories included. Smoke-free and a pet-free home.
That's a shitload of Legos.
Yeah.
Just throw them in a fucking thing and take them. That's a giant pile, dude.
I'm sick of stepping all over these damn Legos. Will you get rid of them? Yeah. What about OfferUp?
Mr. Potato Head was just as fun.
Yes. I absolutely love the Mr. Potato Head commercial where he comes home and she's in the closet eating a bag of potatoes. But you're a potato.
Y'all are fucking with me now. $50.01. $151.
Jeez, people. All right, here we go. I have no idea. That's a big-ass pile of Legos. That's all I know.
$50.02.
I'm going to step on that in the middle of the night. You're going to say some words. $200 takes it all.
Dova.
The breeze.
Warning. 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 Dova alert. Dova alert.
It's a party. It's a party.
RF Tech, I could build a something.
Number four.
I could build a, you know, something.
CJ on the end.
A CJ. Oh, that one's hard to get off the wall. I'll get back to you when I get off the wall. You get to tie for first place.
Wow, the breeze.
Wow. Comes in out of nowhere to tie for... I meant two, but you're taking that one. You're getting tied for first place. We can take it back if you want, but I think you'd rather have that one. Uh-huh. I do declare. I get you.
I do declare.
I do declare.
Very good, very good, very good. Very, very, very good.
All right, here we go. A scale. Look at the size of that scale. That's not like the baby scale that we had last week with the dirty baby asses. This is an authentic John Chatillion and Sons antique hanging produce scale. It functions but needs to be cleaned inside to work well. It has mud dauber nest inside from hanging outside. The tray is baked on porcelain with enamel finish. The patent date, 1914, and the patent numbers are still legible on the face. They also have a metal cone piece that was used to weigh poultry and a metal fish weighing container. Now, that's a big fucking scale. That's how you weigh fat guys at the goddamn fair.
Horses and shit. I'm
going to have to get the mud dauber nest out of it, though.
Yeah, the mud daubers screw it up.
Goddamn mud daubers.
Could use a little paint, too.
I could use a little paint. I'm going to say a little crazy. Everybody's hitting Google. I'm not. No Googling. I haven't seen a train tonight. Nobody's got one train. No. Nobody's been on the train. The train's got to go back in the station. Nobody's riding a train.
Yep.
But to be the man, you got to beat the man.
All right. To be the man, you got to beat the man that said the right price is... We're not weighing dirty asses on this one. We're weighing meat. $138.
Dilly with 135.
Dilly with 135. I'm banned from Googling. My wife caught me looking for plastic stuff. Nice. Nice.
But honey, they said it wasn't cheap.
Eating ain't cheating.
Now I'll take the Dilly one. Look at that. He was very patient.
Very patient. He worked his way over and got it. And now he's going to get... Well, he's going to take -5. He's going to take 5 points away from that.
Alright, that's still easy with 10.
Still got 10. I mean, you're not totally out.
So the Breeze is in first with 14. Dilly with 10. Nitwit with 8.
Mm-hmm.
You know what time it is now?
It is time.
Don't!
To get down to the last one.
I mean.
And what happens on Shopping with Craig on the last pick?
What happened with Shopping with Craig stays with Shopping with Craig. Oh, wait, no.
That's right. But since it's the last item.
We are the only show on the internet
that allows you to pass the pick.
You can pass it. Or take it for yourself if you feel greedy.
So you can pick an envelope or you can pass the pick to any other player.
Simple. Simple.
The Breeze has 14.
It's past Geo time, says Nitwit.
The Breeze has 14. Dilly has 10. Nitwit has 8. First one in gets their choice.
Here we go. The item up for sale is a 23-foot boat with a chick with big tits on it. It's a 2006 23-foot polar boat. It has polar problems? Low hours. Maintenance on the boat is yearly. Twin 154-horsepower Yammy hauls. Cuddy cabin with a microwave, refrigerator, sink, and a turlet. Sleeps too comfortably. Holds up to 8 people. It's a great fishing or family boat. Our family used it for going to Egmont Key, Shell Island, Fort DeSoto, and running a few kilos back and forth to Cuba. All right, there you go.
It can hold about 20 kilos.
They can hold 20 kilos comfortably?
Comfortably.
Wow.
Look at those tits. You don't get those tits that
those
cheap.
Those are nice.
Look at Stan. 30K and .00001. It seemed like they picked up a train here at the end. 30,002. Runs only on titty mode. Buyer beware.
Man. RF Tech with 31. Dilly with 30. Show with no name with 25. Mom's Pepsi 25-50. Geo at 30. Joss with 50. We're right around the ballpark. But who's going to bring it in?
You ready?
It's the person that said the actual retail price without going over. $30,000 on the bone. Dilly.
Warning. Warning.
Dilly. Geo will share the points.
Alert.
No, there was no sharing on the last pick.
Oh, that's true. You can't share.
Can't share.
Dilly, it's all you. Pick it or pass it. And the Dilly double is still up there.
The
yes,
Breeze.
It is.
The Breeze has 14. Dilly has 11.
Think Nitwit about it, Dilly. 8. Think about it. Think hard. I'll give you 10 seconds.
The Breeze, 14.
Dilly says, fuck it, I'm going for it. I want number 2.
Left to right, baby.
I'm going number 2. That's the one I'm taking. Well, you didn't take number 10. The Mom's Pepsi, you didn't take. And that was... Oh, damn, Dilly. The Dilly double. Damn it! Damn it, that would have been great, but instead you get to hear that one. And you didn't pick this one, and it was give any other player 10 points. So that's not a good one there. You didn't get that one. That means you're going to be officially damn it, man. Damn it. God damn it, pal. Tied with Geo. Is that good or bad?
Geo wasn't on the board tonight. He had 0. Geo is usually up there at the top.
So that means you lost all your points there. That's going to make who our grand...
The Breeze.
The Breeze will be the
they
champion.
They call me the Breeze.
The Breeze blew his way in here and got himself a victory. Congratulations to the Breeze. So with that in mind, Breeze, what we're going to do right now, if you have a drink at home and you would like to toast, if you're a smoker and you want to smoke some, you know, you can do that too. If you're a heroin junkie, I suggest you throw it away and try to find something else. Stuff a brownie in your mouth, eat some cereal, whatever it is.
Fire it all.
It's time to toast up the Breeze. The Breeze.
We prefer Fireball.
Summer Breeze makes me feel fine.
Seals and Crofts.
Who? Oh.
Seals. Crofts.
Oh.
Yep.
All right, everybody, get your elbows up, your glasses down, tilt it back, and have no more frown.
Glass up, elbow down, tilt it back, no more frown. Stan made that up in like 3 seconds.
Working
right here.
On new toes for you to get out of that damn shoe.
Now, wait a minute. Stan invented that right
here.
Yeah,
that's true.
He invented it right here. He was sitting right there, and he just came up with that.
But there once was a girl
who lived in a shoe.
She smokes the dope.
She drinks booze.
She's not a virgin.
That's no sin.
She's still got the box.
The breeze came in.
The breeze came in.
Cheers, breeze. It's a Kmart Blue Light Special.
I like that.
Cheers, Dilly.
Cheers, guys. Good round.
Sorry you guys didn't win, but
sprinkles are for winners.
It's pretty awesome to go as far as you did.
Yeah, it was a good round. It was quick.
Hello.
I was talking about the girls' basketball.
Oh.
Thing.
Yeah. That too.
They got bumped out of there.
That too. That sucks.
But he got a free cross-state trip.
He drove
across the state with his family.
Nothing wrong with
Mrs.
that.
Mrs. Dilly with him the whole time, and nothing. The freaking deer had to stay home.
See? That's
the
a
Dilly
bonus.
The deer had to stay home.
Stay home, deer, and sleep
you
outside.
Ain't my
you
shit.
Son of a bitch, I'll chain you to a tree.
Mom still calls foul.
I still call a foul. We'll get a new toast.
Gio says, it's not about winning.
It's about playing the game.
It's about not fucking losing. That's what it's about.
Because losing sucks.
Losing sucks.
You don't think so? Ask the plastic bitch that gets humped every weekend at the fucking New
York. Yeah, if I'm a loser for fucking her, what is she?
A cum dumpster.
Exactly.
All right, we're going to head over to the board, check out the Twisted Topics, and we'll come back. We'll do round two of Snapple when we come back. This time you get to guess the flavor, Breeze. You get to guess the flavor. Guess the flavor of Snapple when we come back. And you get two picks. Two picks at the
Two picks if you get the flavor right.
Yep. Very simple. All right, we're going to go head over. We'll be right back. Sit tight. We're not going to go far.
Woo!
Kicking it and kicking it and kicking it back.
Stop whining.
I'll take those flavors now.
Good evening from the STV newsroom. Live in the shed with your half-blind, deaf, gray-haired, geriatric correspondents, Buddy and Harry. The Twisted Topics.
And action!
Hey, how you doing, buddy?
Hey, I'm glad to be back.
Yeah, me too. How's your vacation?
It was sweet. I went over to Bermuda.
How was that?
It was sweet.
I spent a week at SeaWorld.
Yeah, Bermuda, Arkansas. It was pretty cool over there.
Bermuda, Arkansas?
Yep.
You make any moonshine while you're down there?
I went horseback riding, though.
Really?
Yeah, I was checking out these appliances, you know. They were pretty cool. Old-fashioned, like, ice boxes and the old-fashioned wood-burning stove.
How about, like, an old-fashioned washing machine where you turn the handle and your clothes went through?
And wring them out. That was cool.
That was a lot of work.
Yeah, for the woman.
Yep.
I chop wood.
I hate chopping wood.
My wife chop wood at night.
I like getting wood, but I don't like chopping it.
Hell yeah. Hey, I wonder what kind of warranty would come on some kind of old machine like that.
I don't even know if there was warranties back then.
You don't think so?
No.
What happens now, I think they're pretty fucked up.
You pay for... What's funny is most things come with a warranty now.
Yep.
For like 90 days.
That's all.
And if you want the extended warranty, well, that's going to cost you.
I don't like paying for that crap.
It's like, well, what happened to the one you used to get with it?
They don't give that shit away no more.
It's kind of like insurance.
Do you have that?
Insurance?
I don't have any.
I have great insurance.
I'm on Obamacare.
USAA, baby, I was in the military.
Nice, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for your service.
Hey, you're welcome. I didn't do much.
Were you in the French Navy or what?
No, I was I was in the Navy, but not the French Navy.
You were a seaman.
Yes.
Like that guy Richard Seaman.
Richard, he used to call the show. Remember that guy?
Had a yard sale.
I'm a deck scrubber.
Call me Dick,
yeah. Seaman, Dick Seaman.
That's right.
But, yeah, warranties. What about Spicoli? He got a new refrigerator, and it's already broken.
That's ridiculous.
Exactly. And it took the guy. He doesn't even have a refrigerator. It's been down for 2 weeks.
He's got an ice box now.
His freezer works.
It's called a cooler.
Your refrigerator don't go to the top floor, you dumbass.
That sucks.
But a guy's got to wait like 2 weeks for a motor under warranty.
So what are they going to do now?
I don't know.
Are they going to replace the motor or replace the fridge?
I think they're going to do both.
Wow, that's stupid.
Well, you know, think about it. If you bought a car and it broke down, would you want to hold on to that car?
I just want a whole new car.
In fear that it may break down in the future?
It might.
You ever hear of a lemon? Some things are just
I like limes.
Shit.
Limes are cool.
Well, if you put them together, you got Sprite and 7-Up.
Put the lime in the coconut and call me in the morning.
Who was that guy? That guy was great. Wasn't he in a James Bond movie or something?
Yeah, that's how cool that commercial was.
Put the lime in the coconut and took it all up. Hey, you doing a limbo? I'm doing a limbo.
Limbo man.
I haven't done that in years. I love the limbo.
What all kind of stuff has warranties? You know, lawnmowers do, I think.
Yeah, they want air conditioners.
Air conditioners.
What about, I think anything appliance in your home, like a microwave.
How about an air mattress?
What if it popped a hole in it?
Damn, what about a waterbed?
That reminds me of a funny story of a guy came home and his waterbed popped and it was all over the living room.
Yeah, he probably hung over too.
Yeah, I think he was.
Damn it!
Hell of a way to end the weekend.
Goddamn dog! I love you too, Vandekar.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Love you too. Yeah, no warranty on that, was there?
Nope.
We didn't even have insurance.
So what doesn't come with a warranty?
What doesn't come in a warranty? I don't know.
Rubbers?
Yeah, exactly.
Sorry, we don't cover that. No. We cover that. But we don't cover that.
Well, I try to cover that.
They're not guaranteed to keep anything
There's
off.
No guarantee down here either.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, exactly.
Never know.
I think a warranty is only as good as what you get.
Yeah, condoms are not warranted. Q-tips, maybe.
Yeah, because you stick it in your ear, clean it out, and then throw it away.
Throw it away.
If brain matter gets on there, then if it doesn't, you don't get brain matter on your Q-tip, you're doing good.
I like that.
That's a good philosophy, right?
All right, well, I think my warranty's over.
Mine expired years ago, and there's no extension for it. See? All right, with that in mind, it's time to go. I'm re-upping on my Cialis.
All right.
Don't!
I mean...
Kids, this week's Snapple Cap Fact coming up right now. Don't go anywhere.
Snapple Cap Fact time, kids. They come 0 through 1,399. I'll give you a hint right now. Guess high. That's all I'm saying. I would guess high if I were all of y'all. I'm just saying. That's all I'm saying. You know what I'm saying?
I do.
I know you know what I'm saying, but can you clearly hear what I'm saying?
Yes, no ragrets?
No ragrets. Ragrets?
That's my credo.
I just came to the realization there's probably a Golden Girls porn parody. Wow, that would be good. It's a pee movie. Get it?
Maud was supposed to be pretty hot. Just saying, Maud was supposed to be pretty hot. Show with no name, Whitey. I don't have a number.
I need a number for Whitey?
RF Tech came with Peach.
And then RF Tech is Peach, okay.
Hold on, I got 100. And...
Breeze, Mom's, and SJ.
Show with no name, 1255.
Okay. Breeze, Mom's, and SJ.
Breeze is 545.
Flavors.
Oh.
Got your numbers, need flavors.
SJ came in with Peach, no.
Jost came in first on my board. What about your board there, buddy?
First up was...
Sting is yellow.
Jost with 235, yes. Jost came in first, correct. Two picks, Jost.
Woo!
$12.99 for Jost.
Good, good, good.
Breeze tea
for
Mom's.
I got Breeze tea from you, Stan. I got that.
All right.
Jost with 1299.
Smitty, I gave you a flavor. Remember, it wasn't a shot in LA'd.
Hello? Hello? This thing on? Hello?
All right, we ready for give it up? One free pick for the person who guessed. Mango tea. Mango tea. I didn't see mango tea up there anywhere. It takes two.
Believe it or not.
To mango tea.
Believe it or not.
It takes two to mango tea. I told you it was a new flavor. I was going to tell you ahead of time. To guess high.
But normally somebody says mango something. They didn't.
Uh-huh. No mango.
Mango Talibana.
Talibana. That could be it. All right. Well, here we go. Let me shake it up. Get a good one. Oh, that's pretty good.
Very strong.
Very good. Very tasty.
Very tasty.
Very tasty. Real fact number. No, that's not it. Not it. It's with a stir stick. Yes. Real fact number one, two, seven, five. 1275. Less than 1% of Sweden's household waste ends up in a dump. Less than 1% of Sweden's household waste ends up in a dump.
That's the way it should be.
1275.
Whitey with 1255.
One, two. Oh, he missed it by 20. Wow.
You missed it by 10 earlier, so we're all over it.
All over
it. I think everybody needs to just pick in the high numbers.
Yeah.
And let's just boom.
Yeah, but last week was in the hundreds, remember?
You know who's going to get it again.
Think I got a shot in the dark?
No.
Oh, yeah.
You knew it wasn't.
It's like getting
happen.
Laid twice in one night.
Off
you know, that
the
shit
window.
Happen. No, it so would never happen
much.
Again. No, they don't.
Sprinkles are for winners.
Like, and y'all use all the toilet paper.
Yeah, y'all don't use half of that in Sweden.
Minnesota.
We haven't used
paper.
That roll yet, so we've been, you know, waiting. That's the emergency, gotta take a shit in a shed roll.
They burn the garbage for energy. That's true.
That's smart.
Yeah.
I would do it.
So what you do is you burn the garbage, create heat, which then turns water into steam, which turns a turbine, which creates voltage.
Are they going to burn the used fucking plastic sex dolls after they wear them out?
That would you got to recycle it.
That'd be the only
imagine way. That sitting in a recycle bucket out front. Yo!
The hell are y'all doing here?
Four or five people have them.
I'm melting.
I recycle everything, bro.
Gross. I don't care. I don't care.
Brother.
Exactly.
Look, if you're going to fuck one of those, you got to own it.
Yeah?
You got to be out front with your arm around
Hello.
Her and shit. That's right.
Hello.
That's right.
Hello.
Just hang out with her. I love you. You're my goddess sex doll of the evening.
Yes.
I just rub it against and guarantee the lights come on. Ah.
Sorry, Stan. I know Vaughn is having some issues. I had some issues tonight.
I'm just not sure about the doll thing. I just know. Good.
I'd do it.
You would?
I think I think
it was at home, you wouldn't go out to a place.
I wouldn't use someone else's.
No.
But no. Personal ownership of one.
Mm-hmm. So.
It's just, where do you store it? Under the bed?
Yeah.
Dog dragged it out.
The dog's humping it. Oh, man, I can't fuck Sally anymore. The dog got it.
Sorry, Father. I didn't mean for you to see that. How many Hail Marys did
The priest comes over.
Oh, my God.
Dogs out in the living room.
Oh,
banging your sex doll as you come in the door. Hold me, God, old lady. What is your dog doing? What is that, my laddie? Say 84 Hail Marys and don't ever come back to me, church.
Ever. I use Flomax.
Oh, that's funny as shit. Lordy, Lordy, what you doing there to the dog? That dog's never been...
You gotta bring it out here, huh? Bad dog!
Bad dog! Bad dog! Get your rocket out of there! Oh, gross!
Yeah. You know what the ultimate shame would be? If you walk in the room and your plastic girlfriend's got a dildo fucking her pussy. You don't do it for me, bro! That's disrespectful!
Hail Mary is fucked, I'm Protestant.
Or if she's cheating on me with another, oh, you could put them in 69, two female dolls.
Yeah, you come in and she's eating out
it's
another
a threesome, female. Honey!
Get out of here! Go! That would be just horrible.
She's cheating on you with your brother.
Oh. Are you finding it? I'm down here. I'm looking for it, honey. I got my miner's cap on.
Oh, that'd be brutal.
Oh, that would be terrible.
Do you sell it at the garage
or
sale?
Or G.I. Joe.
I mean, when you're done with it.
You sell it at the garage sale? Hey, hey.
$40.
Hey, hey, look, look. I see you and your wife are having a few problems. I got this friend. You could put it in your boat and go fishing with her, fuck her out in the water, and, you know, you're sitting there.
It's from a pet-free, smoke-free home.
Can you imagine some fucking fisherman banging that thing out in the middle of the lake? Ah, I am going fishing and I'm banging me plastic girlfriend.
And you get a bite right at the time you stand up. She's there. Hold on, damn it. I can't get
off. Me and Sally won the fishing tournament last year.
The Coast Guard pulls up. Sir, what are you doing?
I was baiting me hook.
Better than being a masturbator.
Come home, she has a strap on. Oh my. Boink, boink, boink. Guess who's getting it tonight? Oh, man.
Damn it.
That would suck.
Honey, I told you I'm a pitcher, not a catcher.
Exactly. I love that Budweiser, but it sure makes my asshole hurt. Ouch.
That was good.
That's good. That's a good one.
All right, well, let's talk about our friend shows.
Yes. Tomorrow night?
Tomorrow night.
Show with no name.
Yep.
They don't need a name. Why have one? They're so good at not having a name, they named the network. No name. Network.
The No Name Network.
Simple. No name. We don't need a no name.
Why
don't
they have good stuff on their network?
Professional podcasts.
Yep.
By non-professionals. I mean, what better could it be?
We're non-professional?
We're totally non-professional. We're some amateur motherfuckers.
Oh, we're almost scientific, though.
Yeah, we are almost scientific.
Almost scientific.
Yep. We learn new words each and every week.
All right, so that's Saturday night.
9 o'clock.
9 o'clock.
Correct.
I'll be at a ball, at an event, a gala.
Smitty will be getting his balls off in a tuxedo tomorrow night.
Tennessee tuxedo. Yes. People ask me what my name is.
Yeah.
I will say Tennessee.
Tennessee tuxedo.
That's going to be on my
tuxedo
name tag.
Tuxedo will not fail.
That's going to be on my name tag.
You're going to say it all night long. I will not fail.
I will not fail.
I'm getting laid at the end of the night. I will not fail.
Yes, it is. It is sex night. And I'm in a tux.
I don't have the link on the top. SpicoliTV.com. SpicoliTV.com. That's our website, moms. You can go there and check out the links page. And there you go. Whitey, thank you.
Yep, you just go there, go to the friends page, and boom, we'll take you straight to the show. Show up tomorrow night, 9 o'clock,
boom.
Click on the link, boom, there they
takes
are.
Takes you right there.
Right?
Get on the chat board.
Right, then what?
One.
After
and
that,
then,
we got what?
Tuesday night, they come back around, show with no name again, 8 o'clock.
They're so good, they go twice a week.
They go twice a week.
We could never go twice a week.
I couldn't even go twice
Much
a month.
Twice in a night.
Wednesday night, you got Randomly Randy. It's been on hiatus for a little while, but they should be back.
Mm-hmm.
That's Wednesday night. Of course, Thursday night.
Two shows. First, it's open mic.
At 7.
7 to 9.
Correct. And then at 10?
10 o'clock is the Nitwit.
Nitwit.tv. What is it again?
Nitwit.tv.
Nitwit.tv. The finest produced video show going today. Yep. Woo! For sure.
You know, the only thing I have to say about open mic, I enjoy their show. They're great. And they got a camera that shoots on their guest.
Mm-hmm.
They need to add another milk crate for both of them so they can
get up a little higher.
And actually be on the TV shot.
Love this. Yeah.
Joe, we got to get you in the shot.
Get up there. Get up in that shot.
Damn.
Get up in there. Got to do that. I'm stealing this promo. Yes, you can go ahead and steal it all you want. I applaud you too. I'll send you more.
Yeah.
Hi,
really.
This is Spicoli, and you're watching the show with no name right here on the nonamenetwork.net. Professional podcasts by non-professionals.
That's right. This is Smitty. Stop jerking off and watch the show with no name. I do.
That's fantastic.
Just saying.
That is fucking great.
I
right
quit
there.
For a little while.
Look at Kirk. Mark that motherfucker.
I may not make it through the whole show, but.
He took a one take Willie over here. That was fucking great.
Just saying. All right, guys. Well, thanks for hanging out, everybody.
Thanks for hanging out with us. Thanks to IRNBroadcast.com. Tons and tons and tons of podcasts for your entertainment. You can find anything from politics to all kinds of stuff. I just checked out another new one this week, and I can't even remember the name of it. I downloaded it, and I listened to it. I'm like, hey, this guy's pretty good. Was
Look
it Ring the Bell or Bell Ringers or something like that? It's something to do with ringing the bell.
Look at Whitey. He goes, I watched this show while jerking off. I don't even slow down.
We suggest you do that. I mean, it makes life a lot easier. So
thanks,
we
Dan.
Have an after show if you want to hang out and listen to some music and comedy while we tear down the studio. We'll provide that for you. I've got a little bit of Rolling Stones tonight, mate. I don't know if I, you know. Hey, how much good music they wrote, man.
Angie?
No, not Angie. Fuck
Angie!
No.
Angie! Oh, say, is Angie over there? You're going to need an angioplasty.
Oh, Angie. Is your doll got Angie?
How many hits did the Stones really have?
A fucking 100.
100? No.
Least. Yes, they
name
did.
Name three.
Name three?
Yep.
Do-do-do-da-da-da. No, wait, that was not them. That was the police.
Do, do, do.
That was the police.
Da, da, da. No way. All right.
I don't know. I don't know.
Rolling Stones?
How many stones did you throw? I don't know. How many stones did you piss out? I don't know. Ouch. That would hurt. Paint It Black. Great show. Great song.
Hey, now you could also get a black girl.
Yeah.
Final.
Yeah.
You could.
What if you get a Puerto Rican, what's her name? What's her name?
What is a quince?
What if she's sitting there banging?
What is a quince?
Oh, that's awesome. Get a voice recorder.
Get a voice recorder?
Billy, the Stooky brothers are coming, Billy, and me too. Oh, what is
jackhammer
a quince?
Me. Jackhammer.
Jackhammer me, Billy. Jackhammer me.
And if you want to get a vinyl sex doll, just go to our website. Yeah. We've got the link right there.
Oh, Maria Conchita Alonso. I like her. What a whore she was.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Pac-Man. What you looking at, Pac-Man? Remember Colors? What a great movie.
Yeah. Dilly, thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. Sorry y'all won the chartreuse ribbon.
Yeah, sorry you got the runner-up ribbon. But you know what? There's always next year, so look forward to that.
Minnesota, thanks for hanging.
Thanks for everybody. Mom's Bitch.
Mom's Pepsi.
Jost, IRN Broadcast, Geo, Smitty, Nitwit, Mom's Pepsi, Dr. No, Dilly, Vaughn, Sticky Jello, The Breeze. Thank you, Breeze, for checking out and hanging out with us as well. Showing their name, and of course, our friend, RF Tech. Build you anything in the world you want. Just got to keep it on the down low. All right, guys, have a good night. After show is next. Stay tuned.
The faces of Mike and Stan next week.
Stop whining.
They won't do it.
Stop whining.
All right, you ready?
Yes, sir. Hit it.
All right, see you next week.
Stop whining.
All right, kids, that's all for this week. We want to thank you, the viewer. Without you, this is not a show. The show is hosted by Spicoli and hosted by my man, Smitty. Your audio director is Harry, and your video director is Brian. That's all, folks. See you next week. This is a Spicoli TV Entertainment production.
So,
good, good.